Dear friends, till now we have discussed that what do we understand by offer acceptance and what are the rules regarding valid offer and valid acceptance. In the last class also we have discussed that if we talk about offer and acceptance, so we have discussed that acceptance is just like a matchstick to the gunpowder of the train. So once the offer is accepted, so here we are talking about that it's a valid offer, and we are here talking about it's the valid acceptance. It means it carries all the essential elements to for the which are required for the formation of the contract. So once the contract is there, then you cannot take your steps back. And we have also discussed that under what circumstances there is termination of offer, right? So under what circumstances offer comes to an end, or there is a lapse of offer, or it means that it cannot be accepted anymore. It can't be accepted. So it means that once there is a situation of termination of offer, so there is not going to be the resultant item as a contract. So us situation mein, we have to understand the next topic, that where it says that what is the time of communication of offer, acceptance and revocation. It means that kis circumstances mein aur kis situation mein ye mana jayega ki offer jo hai dusre person ko communicate hogi. What is the time of communication of offer? So it means there is possibility that A has posted a letter on one particular day, say on 1st of December. So when he posts the letter of 1st of December making an offer, so does it mean that offer is being communicated? Or when the acceptor receives the particular letter on say 3rd of December, then one, will it be considered at that point in time? When he receives the letter on 3rd of December and he posts the letter of acceptance on 4th of December, and this letter reads to the offeror on 6th of December. So what are these, situation? At what point in time it will be considered that communication of offer is complete as per law, or communication of acceptance is complete as per law? Or kis situation ke andar, if a person is making an offer, to humne discuss kiya tha ki termination of offer jo hai, wo wahan par bhi ho sakta hai, where the person withdraws it by giving the notice of revocation. To us condition mein, revocation ka communication aur uski legal effect jo hai, wo kab complete hoga? This is our next topic which we have to discuss today. So what we are going to discuss today, is it clear to all of you? So offer acceptance is being classified into three parts. One, offer. What do we understand by the offer? What are the legal rules of the offer, and under what circumstances there is termination of offer? Then we have discussed that what is acceptance, what are the legal rules of valid acceptance, and the third one is about the communication of offer, acceptance and revocation. So generally the legal rules of valid offer and acceptance are interlinked, and there can be a likely question or some case study with respect to the communication of offer, acceptance and revocation. So jab tak hame ye nahi pata hoga ki wo legal offer aur legal acceptance ke form mein exist karti hai, so we won't be able to understand the concept of communication of offer, acceptance and revocation. So let's see the concept of communication, or when it is considered to be complete as per law. So now here we say that communication of an offer is considered to be complete when it comes to the knowledge of the person to whom it is made. So if I see my example here, so I have written that A has posted the letter of offer on 1st of December, and this letter reads to the B to whom the offer is being made on 3rd of December. So it means if I talk about this particular definition or rule, so it says that when the letter is being posted on 1st of December, the communication of offer would be complete on 3rd of December when it comes to the knowledge of the offerer to whom it is being made. So if we say this word point, that when communication of offer is complete, so A has posted a letter of offer on 1st of December, which reads to B on 3rd of December. So as per the rule, the communication of offer is complete on 3rd of December. It says when it comes to the knowledge of the person to whom it is being made. Right? Is it clear? Yes, the first step, first stage is clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So it means that we have to remember the rule that communication of offer is complete when it comes to the knowledge of the person to whom it is being made. So if it's a journal offer, then in that case, this journal offer, you have given the advertisement in the newspaper. But unless the other person reads that particular advertisement or try to enter into the particular contract, this communication is not complete. So just making an advertisement does not mean that the offer is communicated. Unless the person reads the information, acts upon it, then there is going to be the communication is complete. Now, the second stage comes, communication of acceptance. Now we say that communication of acceptance is complete at two stages. We say that communication of acceptance is complete at two stages. One, against the proposer, that is who has made the offer. And second, against the acceptor. The person who is accepting the offer. Now in this case, when we talk about against the proposer, so when the acceptance is put into the course of transmission, that stage is the stage when the offer against the proposer, the communication of acceptance is complete, or is stage ke baad offer revoke nahi ho sakti. And against the acceptor, when it is complete, when the acceptance comes to the knowledge of the other party, comes to the knowledge of offer. Offerer is a person who proposes, who makes an offer. Offeree is a person who is to whom the offer is being made. And if the offeree accepts the proposal, he becomes the acceptor. So communication of acceptance is complete against the proposer. So humne date li thi 1st, 3rd, 4th and 6th December. Have I mentioned the correct dates? As per our example,
yes.
Okay. So in this case, first ko usne offer ki, third ko wo offer offeree ki knowledge mein aayi. So communication of offer complete hua 3rd December ko. Ab then the offeree took one day to decide and he put into the course of transmission his acceptance on 4th of December. So proposer ke against aapki jo acceptance ka communication hai, wo 4th December ko hi आपका कंप्लीट हो गया. तो बिफोर द लेटर इज पुट इन टू द कोर्स ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस, तो इस स्टेज तक ऑफर रिवोक हो सकती है. ऑफर कैन बी रिवोक्ड बिफोर द कम्युनिकेशन ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस इज कंप्लीट अगेंस्ट द प्रपोजर. तो अगर एक बार ही एक्सेप्टर ने अपनी एक्सेप्टेंस डाल दी कोर्स ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन में, कंडीशन बीइंग दैट इफ ही हैज सेंट इट बाय मेल, तो वो राइटली एड्रेस्ड होना चाहिए, राइटली मेंशन होना चाहिए. So in that situation, it is required. Or against the acceptor kab complete hoga? When it comes to the knowledge of the proposer ki acceptance ho gayi hai. To yahan par hum acceptance ko revoke kar sakte hain. Ki acceptor have the space in between दैट ही कैन विड्रॉ हिज एक्सेप्टेंस. तो अगर उसने एक्सेप्टेंस विड्रॉ करी है और आपकी लेटर ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस और लेटर ऑफ रेवोकेशन इकट्ठे पहुंचा है, तो उस सिचुएशन में वो जॉन जोन से लेटर पहले ओपन करेगा. द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विल बी डिसाइडेड ऑन दैट सिचुएशन. इफ ही ओपन द लेटर ऑफ रेवोकेशन फर्स्ट, देयर इज नो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. एंड इफ ही ओपन द लेटर ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस फर्स्ट, देयर इज अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड रेवोकेशन विल नॉट हैव एनी मीनिंग. सो सिमिलरली हमने ये रूल डिस्कस किया था कि हमें नोटिस ऑफ रेवोकेशन के अंदर अगर वो जर्नल ऑफर है तो सेम मोड यूज करना है, और अगर वो जर्नल ऑफर नहीं है, स्पेसिफिक ऑफर है, तो रेवोकेशन के लिए हम कोई सा भी मोड यूज कर सकते हैं. सो नाउ यू सी कम्युनिकेशन ऑफ एन एक्सेप्टेंस इज कंप्लीट अगेंस्ट द प्रपोजर व्हेन इट इज पुट इन द कोर्स ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन टू हिम सो एज टू आउट ऑफ द पावर ऑफ द एक्सेप्टर. सो इट मीन्स कि इसका मतलब कि इस स्टेज पे हमारी एक्सेप्टेंस हो गई फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ दी ऑफरी. सो उसकी तरफ से हमारी एक्सेप्टेंस हो गई है. सो अब इस स्टेज के अंदर हम ऑफर रिवोक नहीं कर सकते. नो रेवोकेशन ऑफ ऑफर इज पॉसिबल. आर यू गेटिंग द कंसेप्ट? आर वी ऑन सेम पेज?
यस
यस,
मैम,
ओके, राइट. देन अगेंस्ट द प्रपोजर, अगेंस्ट द एक्सेप्टर व्हेन इट कम्स टू द नॉलेज ऑफ द प्रपोजर. सो यू कैन रिमेंबर दीज डेट्स, और हाइपोथेटिकली यू कैन क्रिएट द डेट्स योर सेल्फ एंड यू कैन क्रिएट द एग्जाम्पल योर सेल्फ, राइट. सो दिस इज अबाउट द कॉम्युनिकेशन ऑफ ऑफर एंड एक्सेप्टेंस. नाउ इट सेज दैट व्हेन एक्सेप्टेंस इज गिवन बाय पोस्टल मीडिया, द ऑफरर becomes legally bound by acceptance, although the letter of acceptance is delayed or lost, but properly it is properly addressed and stamped and proved to have been mailed. तो अगर ये कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई होती हैं, तो अगर आपकी लेटर डिले भी हो गई या फिर आपकी लेटर वी कैन से लॉस भी हो गई, बट इफ वी हैव द प्रूफ दैट वी हैव पोस्टेड द लेटर एंड इट हैज बीन प्रॉपरली एड्रेस्ड, इट हैज बीन प्रॉपरली स्टैम्प्ड, इट मीन्स द इंटेंशन ऑफ द पार्टी वॉज टू एक्सेप्ट द ऑफर, देन इन दैट केस इट विल लीड टू एक्सेप्टेंस. यू कैन नॉट विदड्रॉ द ऑफर, यू कैन नॉट टेक इट बैक. सो फॉर द सेम थिंग आई टोल्ड यू दैट वेन एवर यू आर मेकिंग सेंडिंग एनी मेल फॉर एनी रिक्वेस्ट, एंटरिंग इन टू एनी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट और बाइंग समथिंग, कीप योर सेल्फ इन सी सी सो दैट यू हैव द प्रूफ दैट यू हैव सेंड द मेल एंड यू हैव द कॉपी ऑफ दैट मेल. सो इवन दैट मेल इज ओवरलुक्ड बाय द अदर पार्टी, बट स्टिल यू हैव द राइट और यू हैव द प्रूफ फॉर द एक्सेप्टेंस. इज इट क्लियर? सो लेटर ऑन
यस
दीज
मैम,
दीज थिंग्स हेल्प्स अस इन डूइंग अवर वर्क इन अ बेटर वे. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स. इट्स नॉट दैट फ्रॉम द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, बट इन आर डेली प्रैक्टिस और डेली रूटीन वी कैन लर्न दीज थिंग्स इन अवर यू नो टू इम्प्रूव अवर एफिशियंसी, राइट. सो द केस लॉ आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस बिकॉज आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड द एग्जाम्पल एंड इट इज ऑन द सेम लाइन्स, राइट. नाउ लेट्स मूव अबाउट कॉम्युनिकेशन ऑफ रेवोकेशन. वेन वी टॉक अबाउट कॉम्युनिकेशन ऑफ रेवोकेशन, सो रेवोकेशन मीन्स टेकिंग बैक, ठीक है. तो वो रेवोकेशन जो है, विड्रॉल जो है, वो आपका ऑफर का भी हो सकता है और एक्सेप्टेंस का भी हो सकता है. सो इन दिस केस टेकिंग बैक द ऑफर और टेकिंग बैक द एक्सेप्टेंस. बट द रूल सेज दैट इफ द ऑफर इज स्पेसिफिक ऑफर, सो मोड ऑफ रेवोकेशन कैन बी एनी. इफ यू हैव सेंट अ लेटर ऑफ एक्सेप्ट लेटर ऑफ ऑफर, यू कैन मेक अ फोन कॉल टू विदड्रॉ दैट ऑफर. इफ यू हैव सेंट अ लेटर ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस, यू कैन सेंड अ टेलीग्राम फॉर द सेम. Or if you have sent the letter, you can send the letter as well. So again, it would depend upon that which particular letter is opened by the other party first. And when we talk about the acceptance, so acceptance can be taken back again in the same mode. But when we talk about the journal offer, in case of journal offer, it is to be withdrawn only by the same mode by which it has been made. So you cannot say that if you have advertised in newspaper, so offer is being made in HT and the withdrawal is being done in ET. So that is not possible. So this, if you have made the offer in HT, so you have to give the revocation in HT itself. Withdrawal of the offer should be in the same, so that it is assumed that the readers of the particular newspaper are same. So even though there can be some changes, but as a legal rule, we consider or we presume it to be same. So when we talk about the revocation, so revocation means withdrawal. Withdrawal means taking back, be it the offer, be it acceptance, and communication of the revocation is complete against the person who is making it when it is put into the course of transmission. अगर offerer withdraw कर रहा है revocation, तो उसके against कब complete हो जाएगा? When it is put into the course of transmission, right? And if acceptor is withdrawing or revoking his acceptance, then in that particular case, the acceptance will be, again, the acceptor, it will be over when it is put into the course of transmission, right? So we have to remember this rule that whosoever is withdrawing, whosoever is revoking, be it offer or acceptance, the communication of revocation is complete against the person to whom it is being made, where so as to out of the power of the person who makes it, and as against the other party when it comes to his knowledge. So this rule we have to remember. So against a person who is making revocation, to wo revocation ka letter bhej chuka hai, to wo revocation ka letter wapas nahi le sakta, and against the person to whom it is being made, to chahe wo offerer hai ya acceptor hai, to wo revocation ka communication kab complete hoga? When it comes to his knowledge. So if we have put the dates, first 3, 4, and 6. Offer can be revoked anytime in between this particular period, and revocation can be revoked anytime in this particular period. So, agar offerer ne revocation ka letter bhej diya, to offerer ke against jo hai communication complete ho gaya, usi time pe jab usne letter of revocation usme post kiya. And acceptor ke case mein, jab wo acceptor ne revocation ki, apni acceptance revoke ki, to wo usi time acceptor ke against complete ho gaya, because now this letter of revocation is out of the reach of the acceptor, to reverse ho jayega. Jabki humne communication of acceptance mein kya discuss kiya tha, ki acceptance mein hamara communication of acceptance against the proposer complete ho jata hai when it is the put into the course of transmission. But communication of revocation ke andar, wo kab complete hota hai, the person who is making it, just time they have put it into the course of transmission. So with this, we can, see that what is the exact time of revocation. So in this particular say, we can say a proposal can be revoked at any time before the communication of acceptance is complete as against the proposer, but not afterwards. So the offer can be withdrawn any time before acceptor sends the acceptance. So agar usne fourth ko apni letter of acceptance dali hai, to fourth se pehle aap apni offer revoke kar sakte ho. So yahan par aapka revocation of offer is possible, but once the acceptor has put into the course of transmission on fourth, so letter of revocation does not have any meaning. And acceptance can be revoked any time before communication of acceptance is complete against the acceptor, but not afterwards. So letter of acceptance sixth ko reach kar rahi hai, to fourth or sixth ke beech mein acceptance jo hai wo aapki revoke ho sakti hai, theek hai? Then acceptance can be revoked any time before the acceptance comes to the knowledge of the offerer. So acceptor should ensure that the revocation reaches the offerer before acceptance. So agar sixth ko acceptance de di offerer ne, acceptance complete ho gayi, so now it exists in the form of the contract, and jab wo contract ke form mein exist karega, to us situation ke andar kya hoga, there is a legal obligation. So once the offer is being accepted, it exists in the form of the legal obligation, then in that case you cannot withdraw your steps back out of the contract. So इसीलिए हम discuss करते हैं कि contract form कब होगा, contract आपका बनेगा कब. तो अगर वो particular situation आपके contract के form में exist कर रही है, so it means that the rules of Indian Contract Act applies, and rule of Indian Contract Act says कि अगर एक सर्कमस्टांस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट के फॉर्म में एग्जिस्ट कर रहा है तो वी हैव द लीगल ऑब्लिगेशन, पार्टीज हैव द राइट्स एंड ड्यूटीज टू परफॉर्म एंड दे आर बाउंड टू परफॉर्म, और अगर वो परफॉर्म नहीं करते हैं तो हमारे पास रेमेडीज एज पर द इंडियन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट अवेलेबल है, जिसके बेसिस पे आप दूसरी पार्टी को या तो कंपेल कर सकते हो परफॉर्मेंस के लिए, या फिर आप नॉन परफॉर्मेंस के लिए उनसे आप कॉम्पनसेशन डिमांड कर सकते हो. राइट, सो फ्रॉम माई साइड दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक इज ओवर. सो इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरीज यू कैन डिस्कस योर क्वेरीज एंड वी कैन यू नो डिस्कस द डाउट्स एंड द रिस्पेक्टिव केस स्टडीज वी आर